Brother David, you ask God's blessing.
Thank you. offended or just clear the screen.
You only die once. If I was going to die, this would be the place I'd die, right here.
That's it. We'll keep it out here so that nothing does happen. Well, I'm Trout. I'm always thrilled to have a water baptism. It's been a while since we've had one, but we have quite a few candidates, and I always meet with each one individually. I've been in all their homes, with their parents. Those are the young people that have all been happy. Some are here, some couldn't be here. We love the outreach to our youth, and Bob's going to be helping me. He's our youth pastor, and he's a blessing, a magician, so many ways here at Bethel. And done a wonderful work with these kids, and God's doing work in their lives. We can see changes after changes after changes, and that thrills our hearts. And so it's with great joy that we're going to be baptizing some of these kids. You have no clue where they come from, some of the things they have to go through in life. Sometimes I do poems with tears, and knowing that really Bethel is their real home, and that this is where they get the support and the love that they need. Others come from much more stable homes, but some don't, and they've got a tough life. And it's good that they know that they have a place of refuge. They have a place, and they have a family here that loves them. And it's our joy to introduce them and have them share their testimony, those that can. Some said they couldn't, and I understand that. The greatest fear of man is to stand in a church or stand in a public place and make a speech. Most people would rather die than do that. So if they can, I'm going to fill in the gaps for them and share what they've shared with me. But we know that each one of these love the Lord and are pursuing God. And one of those steps to pursuing God is to be baptized. Jesus commanded us to be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost as a witness to the church. Water doesn't save anyone. You can't even wash dirt off half the time. There's only one thing you can wash us, and that's the blood of Jesus Christ. But our obedience to Him helps us to grow closer to Him. And so we're baptizing them upon their confession of faith, and we're baptizing them because they've been obedient to the Lord. And they want to follow Him and do everything He asks them to do. And this is just one of the preliminary steps that they're taking, that say, Lord, I'm going to go all the way with You. That's what wet baptism represents. Walking in this water says, I'm going to follow You. Being buried says, I'm dying to this old world. And when we raise them up, they say, if they're saying to this congregation, we're going to walk in newness of life. We have been resurrected with Jesus Christ with the power of the Holy Spirit, and we're going to live that new life in Christ Jesus. For if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away, behold, all things are become new. And I'm going to walk that way. That's what these young people are saying. And we're going to have a few adults. And we're looking forward to that. We see God do some wonderful works in their lives. And we just are thrilled to be able to baptize them today. Amen? So feel free to clap your hands, take pictures, whatever you want to do. And we'll just get into the ceremony now. First one we have is Troy. And Troy is just a wonderful fellow, loves God, and is having a real struggle. I was with him in the school the other day. And we love Troy. God's done a wonderful work in his life. And share your testimony, Troy.
Well, I was already baptized in the church once, and I drifted away. Now I know that when you get baptized, this is a real, it's a commitment that you are saying, not only to your church members, not only to your family, but it's a commitment that you tell in the world, and it's a commitment to God that you are going to walk in faith, and you are going to live for God and follow His commandments. So I'm here today to tell God that I'm going to live for Him and for no one else.
Confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. We now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Lord,
saying, there's anybody that doesn't need any help down in this place, it's her. And then, whatever, so unbelievable.
I have given myself to the Lord, and this is my way of showing my commitment to Him. I'm not good at talking.
We know that Heaven, she's so faithful. She walks sometimes 2 miles to come to church. She's here when we get here. And I see this. She's been 3 years and she's just never missed. And if she's not here, whoa, we begin to worry what's happened. And then usually she'll come on. So we love Heaven and God's doing a wonderful work in her life. And we love her. That's one of our children. Heaven, upon your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, we now baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So I'm pretty honored, and he's going to be baptized in some of these two. I'm just letting him see the practice run. We love Austin. He used to come to our church several years ago, was on the JBQ team, and was 14th in the state of Illinois. And then so many things happened, and he drifted away from the church. We hadn't seen him for years, and all of a sudden he showed up. And a man, a grown up man, he says, I want to get back in. I want to serve the Lord. And it's been here a little over a year now. And just, what a precious guy. I feel like I'm a father to him. I love him. I appreciate his grandma. You've been so good. You've been so good to this guy right here. He loves you very much. And he wants to follow the Lord with all of his heart. And he got his first car. I went with him a couple weeks ago. He got his first car. I got to fix it up a little bit. But, he's moving on, got his GED, he's had a lot of miracles in his life just in this last few months. And so we're thrilled to death with him, happy that he's here with us today for this special occasion.
As y'all know, a couple of years ago, I used to come here, but then stuff happened. Didn't come here anymore, and I slowly drifted away from my dad. After I turned 18, I decided to come back to church, and I'm like, well, I need God in my life. I really did. I was going through a rough time. Started coming here, and everything turned around. Got into GD before I started coming here. I've been baptized here once already, but I don't know, I feel like I'm living. Because I was young at the time, and I didn't realize the power in it. And to be baptized is something big. It's one of the biggest things you can do. It's a commitment that you make to God, showing Him that you're going to follow Him through bitter and follow Him through life or death. Whatever He has for you. And I stand here today to give a testimony that God works. God works. He really does.
Austin, upon your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, the Commander in Chief of your life, we now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Fireball for the Lord, and God's working in her life. She's growing, and Christ has changed her life. I said, Alexis, you stop here to get baptized, and show everybody that you're going to follow the Lord Jesus Christ. And she says, I know. And so share your testimony if you can.
Okay, so I've been to so many churches for a while. I love having my life. And one day there was a event going on across the street, and I went to it, and I was talking to come to church again. When I came, I finally realized I needed to start giving my commitment to God of coming back. Ever since then, I've tried my hardest to come back, and I brought friends that I feel like needed help or that needed God more in their life. And
bless us upon your confession of faith in Jesus Christ, and I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. brother Orlando are going to be baptized, and they've been in the church for some years, and they wanted to be baptized as a testimony to following the Lord. And they were getting a little intimidated with the crowds and everything, and so I think that's why they held off. But we love these guys. They've just been a part of Bethel for a youth group for so many years, and he got 100% on his exam that I gave him for baptism. He did the best of all of them. I was impressed. And I said, hey, Adrian, do you have your homework done? He says, yes. So I came by and I was really impressed. So share your testimony.
I have been Christian since I was 5 years old. This has been my very first time getting baptized.
That's okay. You all said you didn't know if you do it or not, so don't worry, I'll testify for you. This guy loves the Lord. Not only that, he can play volleyball. Adrian, upon your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, we now baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Now the smallest one's coming. This is Adrian's brother. We love Orlando. He's got, I call him the general giant. This guy's got the sweetest spirit of anyone I've ever met. He's just, I've never seen him get upset. I never imagined he's got a bad day. I've never seen it. And just a mellow, sweet spirit, and he loves the Lord, he loves the Lord. It's just been a joy to pastor him all these years, and it's an honor. I've never gotten to get baptized, and David's always too afraid to, and so today is a big day for Orlando. Do you want to say a few words?
First time I'm going to get baptized.
Yeah. It's a big day for him. Orlando, upon your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, we now baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Confession of faith to the Lord Jesus, and I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Now we're going to do something we've not done before. We're going to have a duel come in here to help me out. Joshua, come on in. And Jessica, we just got married less than a year ago. And been at Bethel for this last maybe 8 or 9 months. And we've seen growth. Josh, we've been here before. They've drifted away, come back, married couple. And I've seen a change in Jessica. She never been to church, didn't know anything about God, didn't know about the Bible, nothing. I mean, and she says, I really want to know more. And she's even water baptism and everything. And she just was hungry for more and more. And desires to be used of God. A very difficult past life, struggles and battles. We've grown to love Jessica. And God brought Josh into her life, and Josh knew a whole lot more about the things of the Lord, but he never put them into practice like he needed to. And he's made a commitment for both of them to have to do together as a husband and wife. And Jessica said, can we be baptized together? Because that's why I can't do both at the same time, but I can get you both in the tank and work through it the best way I can. But I thought that was sweet. And I know that they love the Lord, and we are just desirous to see them continue to grow and grow and grow with things of God. Josh, why don't you share your testimony, and then I'll let Jessica share hers, and then baptize you.
Well, I've had a lot of ups and a lot of downs in my life, and right now it's kind of hard for me also. I just quit working for someone recently and started working for myself, so that's kind of a bit of stress on my head, but other than that, the Lord's blessed me my whole life. I've been in and out of church several times. I love everybody here, everybody in the pews. I love all you guys. Anybody that knows me knows how I am. I'm not very much from the speaking out of people, but I speak out my own way. And it's a challenge getting her involved, but I'm doing it, and I'm not going to give up on it. And the Lord blesses me where I go, and that's what I have to say.
This is hard. My first time being in church. Never been baptized. This is my first time. And I want to thank my husband, Brent, for bringing me to church. This ain't the first time I've been to church. I've been to this church for a while, since I was 10 years old, and then the pastor went away. So when I decided to get my life back on track and everything, I've nothing being abused and beat on all my life. So I want God to be in my life to help me through all that. And I want to live for Him like He died for us.
Confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and your desire to follow Him with all your heart. We now baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Josh, upon your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, your love for Him, He's one of the most gifted guys I've ever met in my life, too, just to say something about Him. He's a servant, will do anything for anybody, and gets taken advantage of by a lot of people. But Josh has got a heart towards God. I've seen him weep at these altars many, many, many times. And I love that tenderness about you. I really do. Upon your confession of faith, Josh, in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Two more to go. Well, this girl here, it's been coming for about 2.5, 3 years. This is Stephanie, Kenny's wife. And we all know Stephanie around here. And I've seen her with her ups and downs. This is where her Christian life has been since I've known her. And then all of a sudden, I started to see some stability. I began to see some worship. I began to see a change in her attitude and her confidence. And I thought, wow, she's getting more now. And when we baptized her, it wasn't before, this was when they first started coming here. And it, I don't even think she was ready at the time. Later on, she came to me and told me I wasn't. And I'll let her share. Oh, you can. I don't want her to pass out the tank. That's what she said, I got baptized to please Kenny, to please my family. I just felt that I should do that. But today I'm getting baptized to please God. I want to follow him. I want to serve him. I want to have my heart too. And I want that to be my testimony to this church. And so, Stephanie Grigg, for your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Redemptive power in our lives. Amen. Let's just allow him to have his way this morning as we just stand together and worship him in this place. He's Lord. I'll wait for Matt for a second. He's starting things off today. God don't get in a hurry, does he?
painted in a way that we can know and understand. He went through everything that we could ever go through. He said, I'll stand in their place. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God is so good.
Thank you.
thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ. It cleanses us from all sin. It changes our life. We thank you for the witness of these that have followed you in the waters of baptism. We thank you for their testimony, but most of all for the lives that have been changed, Lord, through your precious sacrifice on the cross of Calvary. Lord, our hearts are made glad in you. They're made glad in you to see, Lord, your followers obeying you and taking those steps, Father, that show their commitment to you. We ask the Lord that you administer in this service, speak to every heart and life. God, let your word go forth in power. Lord, let the gospel that's the power of God unto salvation, be ministered today. Lord, bless you for it. And have your way in the remainder of this service. Anoint your word and everything, and we'll praise you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Lord,
praise the Lord. You may be seated. I believe we have one more special, and appreciate all the musicians and Matt and Reagan have been working on a special song here, and they're going to share with us the first time that Reagan has ever sung in the church. So we're excited for him. They've been working on this for some days, and we're thrilled for that. And God has blessed us. Praise God. It's my oldest grandson, well, other than Rose, and my oldest grandson, yeah. I've got to be so careful now that I got this new adopted girl in the family. I've got to be...
You said grandson, though.
Yeah,
so we're